Hello there. Pluto is the ninth planet in the solar system, until it wasn't. After almost 8 decades since its discovery, its planetary status was revoked in 2006, and thus a cactus strap-on level of butthurt ensued for the loss of the solar system's baby planet. On that note, what makes a planet? And why does Pluto no longer qualify? Let's start with some facts about Pluto. Pluto was discovered in 1930 by Clyde Tombaugh. It was named by the then 11-year-old Venetia Burney, who is now dead. It takes 248 Earth years for Pluto to orbit the Sun, which is to say that since it was discovered, it hasn't even completed half of an orbit. So one day, astronomers of the International Astronomical Union said, "Boy, Pluto sure is smaller than we thought. And there are other bodies of similar sizes, so does that make them planets too? Wait, what exactly is a planet? If we know." So they got together and voted on an official definition in 2006, which clipped Pluto out of the planetary portrait with no shortage of controversy. Meanwhile, I have the sneaking suspicion that Pluto itself is floating along in the cosmos, not giving much of a shit. Furthermore, scientific evidence proves that Pluto is not in the business of giving many shits by the way it orbits the Sun. To illustrate this, here's the Sun. Here's Earth's orbit around the Sun. Here's Saturn's orbit. Here's Uranus's orbit around the Sun. Here's Neptune's orbit. And finally, here's Pluto's orbit around the Sun. Anyway, according to the revised definition of a planet enforced by the IAU, a fully fledged planet must meet these three criteria. Number 1. A planet needs to orbit around the Sun. Pluto obviously meets this criterion. Number 2. A planet has to maintain hydrostatic equilibrium, which is basically a fancy way of saying that a planet needs to have enough mass and gravitational pull to make itself round, or relatively round. Number C. It has to clear its neighborhood, being the most gravitationally dominant body in its orbit. Pluto isn't the most gravitationally dominant body in its orbit. In fact, it's actually in Neptune's orbit.
Sometimes.
So since Pluto only meets 2 out of 3 of these rules, that were kind of made up recently, Pluto was since demoted of its planetary status, and thus Pluto was demoted in the hierarchy of the solar system from planet to dwarf planet. If Pluto were to be reclassified as a planet based on the first 2 guidelines alone, we'd have to include a ton of other bodies as planets, and science exams would become quite the pain in the ass. So it's still kind of a planet, just the planetary equivalent of being sent to sit at the kids' table at Thanksgiving. In 2006, in its 17th annual Words of the Year vote, the American Dialect Society voted "plutoed" as the word of the year. To Pluto means to demote or devalue someone or something. Many efforts are now being made to reclassify Pluto as a planet, and some people are actively working on changing the definition of a planet, again, which may reinstate Pluto's planetary status. But for now, Pluto has been plutoed. I'm Sevy, and thank you for learning with me today. Feel free to smash that subscribe button and big bang that bell. Remember those mnemonics you'd use to memorize the order of the planets? You know, like, "My very educated mother just served us nachos," or some crap? Comment below what type of mnemonic you'd use to memorize the order of the planets. Let your creativity run wild. The funniest one will get a mention in a future video. Until next time.